استغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا ايها الذين امنوا انا من ازواجكم واولادكم عدوا لكم فاحذروهم وَإِن تَعْفُوا وَتَصْفَحُوا وَتَغْفِرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةٌ وَاللَّهُ عِندَهُ أَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِّتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُم مَّوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً بعد اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم ہننا لباس لکم وانتم لباس لہن رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی صدق اللہ العظیم My respected brothers and my sisters, first I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he can grant me this tawfiq and power to my tongue. That today whatever I have in my heart, that Allah can allow me to say it in the best possible way. The topic I have today about family and tarbiyah of children is such a dear topic to me, because as a family doctor and as a family counselor, what I see today in our communities especially, wallahi, it makes me cry. My heart bleeds and I feel the real pain of every family suffering today because of our negligence, because of our ignorance, and because we don't pay attention to this very important institution of our community, family. Brother, there is a difference between knowledge and tarbiyah. Knowledge is just information. That you go to school, or you read a book, or you listen to a speech, that's a knowledge, ilm. Tarbiyah is to train somebody to he can become smart about making the right choices in life. Because life is all about choices, making decision about right and wrong. So tarbiyah is to train somebody to practically, when he faces any challenge, any question, so he can make smart choices. He can make the right choices, my brothers. When we talk about family, you know, family is the most important institution. And the path we have adopted, the way we are living our life today, the pupil we are following, pupil who have already failed, you know, Islam has its own culture, its own tahzeeb, its own way of life, its own approach and perspective of life of this dunya and the life hereafter. The system we are trying to adopt and follow, that system itself has failed. If you read books of authors from European countries and America, these people are trying to highlight only one thing, that revolution, the industrial revolution of 1800, which has brought women out of her house to work, wallahi, all these authors, they are saying that that decision has destroyed the institution of family. And once the institution of family is broken and you lose the focus, you lose your right priorities, then you are lost. We are confused about two things. One is standard of life and one is quality of life. Standard of life counts my house, my car, my business, how much value I have. That's the standard of life. But quality of life is how happy I am in my life and how happy I can keep people around me. The most important thing in family is relationship. And you know, when I say relationship, I does not mean the legal binding that we have husband and wife, we have father and mother and children, we have grandparents. That's not relationship. Relationship is, the meaning of relationship is trust. Meaning of relationship is transparency. Meaning of relationship is that openness, that I am open to communicate everything of my life with somebody. Relationship means the true love for each other. Relationship is that your needs become my desires. Your needs become more important for me than my own needs. That's a relationship, my brothers and my sisters. You know, our crisis today is not an oil crisis. Crisis of money, crisis of businesses, crisis of uneducation. Our real crisis is crisis of relationship. We are not investing enough to nurture, to develop, to make this bond of relationship stronger. Wherever you go, the problem number one you will see, and the reason behind it will be that we have lost this flavor, the spirit of true relationship, my brothers and my sisters. As a father, I feel and I take it granted that my children are supposed to listen to me. No matter what I say, they will follow me because I am the qawwam. I am the authority of the house. Same way is the mother. But my brothers, time has changed. In old days, you used to have control over your kids up to 18 years of age. The studies today are showing in Eastern culture, they can control their children up to the age of 13. But in Western culture, you have control over your children up to 10 years of age. After that, you don't have control over your children. So whenever, inshallah, I will go in detail about this relationship, brothers, that we need to really sit down and think and reflect. And we should see ourselves that where exactly we are heading. And we should take the holistic picture. Holistic picture, the entire picture of tarbiya and relationship, my brothers. Tarbiya is all about mentorship. And this is a very important point of my khutbah that I'm trying to highlight. Tarbiya is not a curriculum. Tarbiya is not about, you know, making some rules and regulations. Tarbiya is to bring somebody in your life as a mentor. Developing relationship with somebody that you can trust, you can rely, you can have blind faith. If he says something that means to you a lot, somebody you can admire, somebody you can sit down and share your pain and your happiness. Mentorship is that you have somebody in your life. It could be your father, it could be your mother, it could be any wise friend, it could be any elderly figure in the family who can become my mentor that I can count on, I can go back, I can relate to, I can sit down and spend some quality time. This is what tarbiya is about. Because this is our spiritual need. This is our psychological need. This is our social need to have somebody. Because humanity is on the path right now to make 7 billion islands. that every one of us trying to create our own island, that I want to create artificial walls around, and I don't want anybody to bother me, and I don't want to rely on anybody. I want to be independent, free from everyone around me. This is the way we are heading towards, that we want to create our own island. I am self-centered. I am sufficient for myself. I don't need anybody. But brothers, as a Muslim, as a human being, as a social being, this is our need to have people around us. That's why I say here one more thing about relationship, my brothers. Always, as a Muslim, keep bigger picture of the family. Wallahi, the people who are short-sighted and they see only immediate pleasures and immediate goals in their life, their flight is always very low, and they keep the flight of their children also very low. Our deen gives us a bigger picture. When Hazrat Amr bin Al-As radiallahu ta'ala anhu enters in the house and he sees his wife feeding baby, he says to her, "Don't feed this baby like you are feeding any baby. Rather, feed this baby, you are helping one abd, one servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grow up, to get the strength and power. And this abd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one day when he will be grown up, he will make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will do ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will do service to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And his every action will be your sadaqah jariyah." Have that vision. Have that picture in front of you. Every Muslim should have bigger picture of life. Brothers, most of the time, wallahi, most of the time, we sell ourselves for very little. We sell our life, we sell our priorities, we sell our sakina, we sell our family just for very little things. This is not me. Even the scholars of this country, this continent, the European scholars, they are saying it, that the decision we made to break the family, that was a very expensive decision. The cost we have to pay was very high, but now we have gone too far. It's very difficult to come back. 92% American today, according to the latest survey, 92% American, they say family has very important place in our life. But only 25% American today are married. 66% people born in Mexico are without marriage. 70% people born in Chile, baby, are without marriage. Where are we heading? So as a Muslim, wake up call for you and me is, brother, we are supposed to be the role model for people, not following people who are already failed. We are supposed to be providing light to the people, hope to the people. Our family system, if you remember a few months ago when there was a talk show on CNN, and one of the anchor on the TV was saying that if you really want to live a family life, have neighbor, Muslim neighbor. Muslim neighbor, because you will see their kids, how they behave, how they interact with each other, how parents take care of the family. Our family system is supposed to provide guidance and light to the community we are living in. So we as a Muslim should see the bigger picture of the family, that the family is my Jannah, family is my Sadqa-e Jariyah, family is my legacy. When I will leave this dunya, I will live in this dunya through my family. My brothers, that picture we should have, inshallah, then we will be able to really focus on our relationship. We will invest on our relationship, which is the call of the hour, need of the hour. My brothers and my sisters, I will pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives you me tawfiq that we can reset the button of our life. We can reset our priorities. We can reset the perspective of life we have so that we can really focus on things. They are the real priorities of our life. Because of this importance of this relationship, I want to highlight one more point here. You know, when we are living outside our home, in our businesses, at our workplace, dealing with people outside our family, you really do not need to change yourself from inside. You do not have to change the inner layers of your life and personality. When you are inside your home, we need to work on our inside. We need to work on our inner personality. We should be truthful. We should be honest. We should be transparent. We should be truly loving to each other. You cannot just pretend. You cannot have fake mask on your face when you are dealing with family. This is a system Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created in such a way that if you will be truthful in your dealing, in your relationship, wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showers His mercy and blessing on that family. And let me tell you one more thing. When you have real relationship with your family, in tarbiyah, 90% of the time, you don't even have to say anything. Your priorities of life will get transmitted to your kids without you saying a single word. We have everyday experience. Whatever belief system parents have, whatever priority of life they have, whatever perspective of life they have, it gets transmitted to their kids without even them saying a single word. If I am a truthful person, if I am an honest person, if I am a transparent person, if I have worked on my inside, if I have changed the layers of my personality from inside, and I really have cleaned my heart, wallahi, you will see the reflection of that in your family, in your children, in your wife. And another thing I will say here about the relationship, you know, husband and wife, you know, they are the key player. They are the key player. And the ayahs of Quran, which I read in front of you from Surah Rum, one of the ayah in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned about لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought husband and wife together, لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا, so you both can get comfort from each other. If husband and wife are on the same page in the house, if they have the same vision and priorities, wallahi, that house becomes Jannah. That house becomes paradise. Then you will see that you will be able to raise your children in a better way. So first thing I will say, that husband and wife, they should sit down and talk and discuss and then plan and set the vision and goal of their life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, Hunna libasul lakum wa antum libasul lahum, because husband and wife, they are dress of each other. They beautify each other. They protect each other. They protect from the harshness and difficulties of life. And they always attach to each other, no matter what the situation is, like your dress. Never leaves your body, is always connected and attached to you, my brothers. And my sisters, just to give you a few highlights about tarbiyah, always, whenever you want to give love to your child, giving love to your child is by default, that we love our kids. But you know, we have to also give them the trust. A lot of times we do show our love, but we do not trust. Trust your children. Whenever you are planning about your children, get them involved in the planning. Most of the time, it's a one-way traffic. Parents plan, and they expect from kids to execute that plan. Practically, my suggestion will be, whenever you are making any plans for your home, for your children, for your family, always involve your kids in that plan. So they can own that plan. They don't feel like they are getting forced to follow somebody else's plan. So always involve your children. Increase their exposure. Whenever I say increase their exposure, wallahi, you know, our education system, I have said this before, our education system is fixed for everybody. No matter if your brain is of this size or your brain is of this size. Your potential is this much or your potential is that much. They want to put everybody in the same frame. Our education system cannot provide you how to really become smart when it comes to choices. Yes, the education system can provide you some information, some knowledge, but for practical life as a parent is your responsibility and my responsibility to widen the horizon of our children. Increase their exposure. When your child is playing, when your child is eating with you on a table, when your child is going out for traveling, wallahi, all these ways your children actually are learning. Increase their exposure. Let them sit down with elders. Most of the time, you know, our kids, when every family is visiting us, our kids are in their room. They are in isolation. They don't want to sit down with people. And because of that, they are losing their social skills. And we as a parent, we bring their attention to something when there is an issue. Rather, we should be proactive. We should teach our children from the very beginning how to become part of the community, how to become part of the social life, how to sit down when elders are sitting there. Next thing I will say, when I say exposure, you know, I heard one thing and it's a $1 million thing. Somebody said, your children, what they learn when they sit down with you or with grandparents or with elders of the family, they cannot learn from any books. They learn gems. They learn experience of life. They get so many tips about life when they sit down with grandparents, with elders of the family or parents. So when I say increase their exposure, let them spend some time with the elders of the family, my brother and my sister. Last thing I will say, try to make life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Sahaba part of the life of your children from very beginning. You know, the society we live in this society, there is no respect of teachers. There is no respect of parents. Respect is gone. In this society, there is no respect for any religious icon. So we are living in a society where people have lost the treasure of respect. Wallahi, the difference between our children and the children born and raised in any Muslim country, the biggest difference is, in Muslim countries, from very beginning, every mother and father and society puts the love of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, unconditional love of Sahaba, unconditional love of the Prophet in the heart of every person. That's why if you go in any Muslim country, that person might not be praying, he might not be coming in masjid, but on the name of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Sahaba, he will never compromise. So I will request, when I say increase exposure of your children, teach them the stories of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, bring and put love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in their heart, the image of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in their heart, the dignity, the waqar, the muqam of the Prophet in the hearts of our kids from very beginning, so they should know who really Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and whenever the respect comes, how we should respect him, and same way the stories of Sahaba. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he gives me this tawfiq, that we really become true mentor for our children. And there is no harm time to time, after all the efforts you have put for the tarbiyah of your children, sit down with them and shed some tears in front of your child and ask your child, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if I have any shortcoming, if I did not fulfill my responsibility as a parent for the tarbiyah of you, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness for me. Wallahi, if your child will see tears in your eyes that you're asking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for any shortcoming for the tarbiyah of that child will not forget your tears. Those tears will go with him long way. Allah.